Have you ever played Ninja Storm 4 and got tired of seeing Xbox and keyboard buttons? Well, it happened to me too, and I found a solution. This is Eddie04, and today we'll learn how to add PS4 buttons into our Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4 on PC. This video is made possible thanks to Josou Kitsune, the author of the PS4 button mods for this game. Now make sure to check the Steam guide, which I added in the description below, and upvote Kitsune. He's a lifesaver. To mod this game, you need to go deep into the game files, extract CPKs, and cook up buttons into USM file, which is quite convoluted. But thanks to Kitsune, it's way much easier. Now keep watching to learn how to easily add your PlayStation buttons into your game. And make sure to watch all the way through the end to understand the pros and cons of modding your game. First thing first, download the mod and software to extract the files. You can find the links in the description below. In this case, you'll need 7zip, which is a free and open source file archiver, a utility used to place groups of files within compressed containers known as archive. And this was created by Igor Pavlov. Now, I make reference to the software developers so that we can download the right tools that we need to use. After downloading the files, we'll extract the button mode. So go ahead and install 7zip. After downloading the file, we'll extract the mod for the PS4 buttons. Now, you can extract it in your desired location. In this case, I would extract it to the download folder. I like having a new directory created when extracting files to ensure they are organized. So I'll just go ahead and right click on this, and I'm going to choose to extract to the same name folder with a /backslash added to it. Let's pause for a second. If you like videos like this, remember to smash the like button on this one. It definitely helps the channel. And if you find anybody else that you believe that needs to learn how to change their gate buttons in their Naruto Ninja Storm 4 game, then go ahead and share this video.
All right, so now we'll locate our Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4 game folder. The fastest way to find it is by loading Steam. Then go to your library and right-click on Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm 4. Then go to Manage and click on Browse Local Files. Another way to get to the game folder is by right-clicking, then selecting Properties, and then go to Local Files and click on Browse. Both methods will take you to the same game folder. Now here we'll have our default files for Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4, and we'll just need to replace the movie1.cpk file in the launch folder. The fastest way to do this is by just drag and dropping the data folder from the mod to the game folder. This would only replace the file which is located in data/launch. Obviously, Windows will ask you to replace the file. Go ahead and do so. If you're using a keyboard or an Xbox controller, you'll wonder, why would you want to do this mod? Well, you might want to use your PlayStation controller for this game, and I created a detailed video on how to make it work on PC from a PlayStation 1 to a PlayStation 5 controller. You can check the video up here. Okay, so now let's test the game with our new set of modded buttons. Believe me, manually modding this game takes a while, from extracting to compressing files and cooking back buttons into the pack. It's a handful.
My final thoughts on game mod like this is that this is a one-trip flight. So after you do the change, pretty much every single time you go into the game, it will show the PlayStation buttons. Regardless of using an Xbox controller or keyboard or any other gamepad, it will always show the PlayStation buttons.
To revert the button icons, you can easily reapply the CPK file I've added to the description below. If you have this game on Steam, then you can verify game file's integrity. But this will remove any mod or emulator added to the game folder.
For the ultimate gamepad on PC guide, go ahead and click here. And for other awesome videos from Edio4TV, go ahead and click here. And to subscribe, click here. Yes, don't forget to subscribe and click on the notification bell so you can be notified whenever I release a brand new video. It's okay, don't be shy. This is Edio4. See you on the next.